Tim Means versus Mike Perry. We got -135 on Mike Perry and +115 on the Dirty Bird. Mike Perry actually opened up around the -185 range and has slowly gotten bet, or we've seen money come in on Means now, and he's gotten bet all the way down to -135 now. And it makes sense once you start running the tape. We have no props on this. Obviously, the fight doesn't go to decision is always a sexy prop when you're talking about two, you know, seemingly finishers in fights. But let's talk about Tim Means first and foremost. So he's 30-12-1 coming off a victory over Loriana Staropoli in a great fight where he showed resiliency. He showed that his chin is, you know, you can somewhat trust it still. Like there are, you know, against heavier punches, it's obviously going to be a little bit questionable. But you see the technique, you see his ability to use his leg kicks to keep the range, to keep the knees going. And he's starting to go out there and start wrestling dudes now too, which should allow him to really, you know, start to implement his jiu-jitsu game, which is heavily underrated, I should say. He's been around the UFC for a while now, and the one thing that has been his has been questionable of his in recent times, and a lot of people are, you know, kind of hesitant to put money on Dirty Bird nowadays just due to his durability. So, you know, he's gotten finished one, two, out of his last four losses, he's gotten finished twice. In that Daniel Rodriguez fight, he got hurt a couple times, pretty bad on the feet, and then tapped to a guillotine choke. And then the Nico Price fight, we know how badass Nico Price is. You know, Nico Price getting lit up for the majority of that fight. Then we see Tim Means, you know, overextend a little bit, and Nico Price counter perfectly and get the victory there. But, you know, since, 2018, he's had wins over Ricky Rainey, Thiago Alves, and then obviously most recently, Loriana Staropoli. Staropoli brings like a weird game plan into his fights. He loves to throw spinning shit, loves to throw flying stuff, has an awkward fighting style, but Tim Means did a good job of kind of stifling that as best as possible, landing great shots from the outside, using his teep perfectly. That's one of his best weapons as well. If he's able to maintain distance with that kick, he's able to really let his hands go and you know, implement his game plan. Mike Perry, on the other hand, we know what he's all about. He wants to go out there and throw bungalows and try to knock your head off. But the funny thing is, we haven't seen him get in a victory via finish since he fought Alex Reyes way back in September of 2017. And that, you know, he knocked down Mickey Gall once in the, I believe it was the second round. But the only other time he's recorded a knockdown, or at least in recent memory, was that Alex Reyes fight. He did not knock down Ponzinibbio, Griffin, Felder, Donald Cerrone, Cowboy Oliveira, Vicente Luque, Jeff Neal. And he obviously knocks down Mickey Gall, but that Mickey Gall fight was a little bit alerting. You know, we saw Mike Perry go out there and kind of get outstruck. Like I was kind of surprised at the type of striking that we were seeing from Mickey Gall. Beautiful body kicks, you know, had some decent success from range, had decent success in terms of, you know, trying to stay out of the way of the big shots, obviously outside of that one knockdown. But that first round looked really good for Mickey Gall. And that's kind of like the stereotypical game plan that you'd see from a Tim Means is, you know, kind of playing the counter game. He's going to be on his back foot here. Obviously, Mike Perry will be the one kind of pressing the gas and kind of throw those bombs and hoping to land on Tim Means. And this is a fight where Tim Means has to make sure that he doesn't slip up, doesn't, you know, overextend too much, doesn't trade in the fire as much as he, you know, we've seen him in the past before, because Mike Perry does have that power. But I'm a little bit questionable of how crazy that power is, considering we haven't really seen him go out there and really finish dudes in a long time. And you know, I rate Tim Means a lot higher than I do Alex Reyes, but the durability has always been a question for Tim Means in his recent career. But if you're talking about skill for skill stacked beside each other, Tim Means absolutely blows Mike Perry out of the water. You know, Mike Perry is a brawler. That's his style. And, you know, kudos to him for kind of recognizing that the stand-up was a little bit harder than it should have been against a guy like Mickey Gall. And he started taking this fight to the ground and just did a good job in terms of, you know, keeping top position, landing some good shots from on top, and staying out of any submission attempts from Mickey Gall. My issue, though, with Mickey Gall is it seems like he has cardio issues. You know, he tried making an excuse after that Diego Sanchez fight. We saw it hinder him again here against Mike Perry as well, where, you know, he has, or at least has said that he has solid jiu-jitsu, and we've seen solid jiu-jitsu from him in the past, but we did not see any of that in this fight against Mike Perry, because by the time this fight was, you know, once this fight started majority, taking place majorly on the ground, majorly, 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 for the most part, on the ground. We didn't really see him implement a jiu-jitsu, no real reversals, no real submission attempts, and nothing that was even close to hitting. And going into that fight, I thought that was Mike Perry's kind of, Mickey Gall's way to win this fight, is to get this to the ground and really show off his jiu-jitsu, and he was not able to do that. However, I believe that Tim Means is, at this point in his career, he probably has better jiu-jitsu than Mickey Gall, and he might be able to implement it a little bit better than Mickey Gall did. So even if Mike Perry decides to go take this fight to the ground, I don't think he's really in the clear in terms of being able to just lay on top of Tim Means and hoping to just grind out a decision victory like he did against Gall. So I think Perry is in a little bit of trouble here. As long as Tim Means doesn't like overextend or really get hurt or anything like that, he could win this fight just from staying at distance. Or even if he wanted to try to take this fight to the ground, he could have some success in terms of landing shots from on top and possibly pulling off a submission of his own. Takedown accuracy for Mike Perry, 46%, not the greatest, but you know, he's had to deal with some solid takedowns from the past from like Santiago Ponzinibbio and Alan Jobang. Most recently, the last person to really take him down has been Santiago Ponzinibbio, which was back in December of 2017. So I'm not sure if the other guys are really so keen on trying to take Mike Perry down anyway. Max Griffin, not really a takedown guy. Paul Felder, not really a takedown guy. Donald Cerrone, we saw him get this fight to the ground. I can't remember exactly how. Actually, it was Mike Perry that actually ended up taking him down. And we saw Cowboy Cerrone pull off a submission there. But yeah, Cowboy Oliveira, not really a takedown guy. Vicente Luque likes to keep most fights on the feet. Jeff Neal, obviously we know what his forte is. And then obviously Mickey Gall, we know he wasn't able to get the fight to the ground on his terms, at least. So I do like Tim Means here, but I'm so skeptical. It's going to be such a sweat going out there and trying to put money on Tim Means here. I'm going to need a lot better than plus 120, which is the best line that you can currently get at Pinnacle. Now, if this line starts to reach that plus 150, plus 170 range or something like that, I might have to take a little bit of a shot on Means here, as I don't believe the odds should be that wide. Even like plus 155, the opener on Means, I think that was a solid spot if you could have gotten your hands on that. But that did not last for long, and now we have Tim Means at plus 115. So I would sit back and wait. You know, I'm recording this pretty early. I'm recording this on Thursday before fight week, and there's still plenty of time for this fight to, or at least these odds to start to shift, especially once the event before completes. We really see a lot of movement for odds, you know, once people start to really fully shift their focus from one event to the next. So I'll be keeping my eye on that. I do have a notification set on best fight odds for Tim Means at plus 150, as I do feel like that's a good spot for him if you do want to take a play there. Because again, skill for skill, Tim Means should have this in the bag, but it's just being able to stay away from those big shots of Mike Perry. And I think, you know, Means would have a better chance. I'd give Means the higher probability of being able to keep Mike Perry on the outside than Mike Perry landing a clean enough shot to put Tim Means out. But again, like I said, the only way I would really take a shot on Tim Means here is if I got solid plus money, and plus 150 is kind of the range that I'm looking for here for Tim Means. So once again, I'll be going with Tim Means to win this fight via decision, as I do believe that Mike Perry is very, very durable. It's been a long time since we've seen him even finished. Well, obviously, Jeff Neal actually finished him, but outside of that, like, he hasn't even been finished in the UFC, so that's very impressive. Sorry, I did miss up. Donald Cerrone as well did get him by submission. So I will go with the safe side, as I don't believe that Tim Means will want to really overextend himself. Unless he goes for a takedown and just really controls Mike Perry from on top, I'm not sure how successful he would be in that. But I do believe that we'll see Means kind of put together a picture perfect performance outside of, you know, hopefully not getting rocked or anything like that. But yeah, I'm taking Tim Means to win this fight via decision.